Welcome in another video, and in this video we'll be looking into another important topic in a Node.js. So in our previous video we saw how to use flame graph and how flame graph will help us to improve our performance. Well, basically flame graph will help us to improve performance of our code, and it will help us to figure out issues we have in our code. In this series of improving performance of Node.js, we are using Clinic.js. Well, Clinic.js provides three different types of graph: Doctor, Flame and Bubble Proof. So we already saw Flame Graph. Now this time we'll see what is Doctor Graph. Well, if we go inside of clinicjs.org, we'll get this type of page in front of us, and they have given some sort of information about how we can make use of Doctor Graph. Well, Doctor Graph gives us four different types of estimation of our code. One is CPU percentage, another one is the memory consumption, then the active handlers, then what is the status of input output handlers, how busy it is. Those type of information you will get with the help of Doctor Graph. Alright, so let's see how we can use it and how will it help us. So now here inside of VS Code, as you can see, I have one code. This is just a basic code. And let me just try to create one Clinic.js graph for it. Well, in order to create graph, we already saw what is the command. This is the command. So you just have to change this word if you are using different graph. So let's say in a previous video we use flame graph. So I simply used flame here. And in this video we'll try to generate Doctor Graph. So I think I don't need to change this word here. Only thing that will change is the name of my main.js file. So let's copy this command and let me go inside of our working directory. So make sure that you have traversed path up to your working directory. And now let me put sudo here because I'm using Ubuntu operating system. And here as a last parameter, I will have to give name of my main file. So app.js is my main file here. So simply put app.js here. Okay, so this file name will keep on changing. So if you want to check performance of some static file, just a JS file, you can write name of that file here. Okay, so after that I need to give my password here. So let me remove this sudo. Okay, so it is giving me error because this directory has no permission to create new file. So let me give that permission. Okay, so now let me go inside of that working directory again. So after that, if I rerun this command, so it has started collecting data from our JS file, and then it has already created the file and it opened that. Okay, so now we have this JS file here, and let me show you what we have in this JS file. So this is the simple data what we have in our JS file, and then after writing this command, it has created one .clinic folder in our working directory and collected some data and then created this HTML file. Well, as you can see here, I currently got this type of graph in front of us. While analyzing data, they have detected these type of problems here. So let me show you how it actually works. This is not a perfect graph because we don't really see any type of data here, because I think Clinic.js simply failed to profile our data. So let me put some simple code here. All right. And then inside of it, I'll use simply 1 second of delay, and then I'll use read file function. Let's see, will it be able to give us some data points or not. So I'm gonna use read sync, and then let me give package dot json. Alright, so I think that should be enough. Let's rerun this. All right. This time it gave us some sort of graph. Okay, as you can see here, we have these some spikes in CPU, and then the memory is this type of memory. Also, we got event loop milliseconds and the active handlers. So our code is working. That means it has CliniQ.js got at least some amount of data to profile our application. Okay, so now we are good up to this point. So now at the top section, as you can see, they have given us all the defects that CliniQ.js find in our code. So first of all, it find CPU usage, then the memory usage, and the active handlers issue. So all these type of issues will be shown by this symbol. As you can see here, this type of symbol is in front of all those graph which found defective by CliniQ.js. So as you can see, we don't have this type of symbol in front of event loop delays because CliniQ.js simply didn't find that type of issue. All right, so let's understand how it works. So first of all, CPU usage is nothing but usage of CPU at that particular time. So as you can see here, one is x-axis, another one is y-axis. Y-axis showing percentage of CPU. So let me show you one detailed graph which will help us to better understand. Okay, so this is the example that CliniQ.js given. So as you can see here, they have detected one issue. Well, this is the demo and detailed example of how CliniQ.js Doctor Graph works. So as you can see at the top section, it has given reason of issue. So they have detected one input output issue in this code, and that's why it has given this red type of symbol in front of CPU usage graph. Adjust right to that message, you will get this type of symbol. It will simply help you to see all those graphs and organize it horizontally or in different type of layout. All right, so if you want to see all those graphs together, you can use this type of layout, or if you just want to see each graph in detailed, you can use this type of layout. The I button gives you different type of themes, which is not that useful. All right, so let's continue with this theme itself. Okay, so now let's understand how first graph works. So as you can see here, there are some spikes which is going above 100%. So you might be wondering that if CPU limit is 100%, how it is going more than 100%? Well, it is not estimation of entire CPU usage. It is just single core occupied that amount of CPU usage. Okay, so if let's suppose you have 4 cores in your CPU, which is quad core CPU, and the single core of a CPU cross this limit. So don't get confused in between all cores and single core. So as we can see, as we know that Node.js use single core for entire implementation, so that's why it is quite obvious that it will cross more than 100% if there is an issue in a code. All right, so this is something that we should fix in our code. All right, let's just move on to the next graph, which is memory usage. Well, as you can see, there are three different types of lines you will get to see here. One is at the top, which is RSS, alright, and another one is THA and HU. But before we understand memory usage, if I hover anywhere in the graph, you will get to see it is giving estimation of all the different type of graphs at the same time. So that means if I want to see what happened at this big spike which consumed 202% of CPU, you can see here there is 4 milliseconds of delay in event loop, and then the heap size and the memory usage is 47, 30, 34 and 15 MB, and then the active handlers was 13. Okay, so this again the useful feature, because if anything, let's say memory is dependent on CPU percentage, then you'll easily get to see and you can easily figure out the things. Okay, so let's continue with the memory usage. So here, as you can see, we have three different types of lines, and let's understand how it works. So you don't need to get bothered with all about different types of lines. You just need to focus on this last line, which is HU, that is heap usage. So we already saw how to profile heap memory in our Node.js application. We use heap snapshot package for that. Again, this clinic.js provides you your heap memory usage. As you can see here, this application is starting from around 14 MB, and then it is going up and up to 90, 21 MB, and then again it is coming down, which is the normal behavior. Well, if you find something that your memory is going up and up, then we already know what to do with that. We have to improvise it. So the second type of line, this last line, is showing you the actual amount of heap memory your application is using at that time. The second line is giving you an estimation that Node.js, the amount of memory Node.js allocated for a particular operation. So let's say 34 MB of memory Node.js has allocated, among that 21 MB our application is using. So THA will always be greater than HU. Okay, you just don't need to worry about RSS. This is of no use. Let's continue with our next graph, and in that graph it is giving us estimation of event loop delays in milliseconds. As we know that Node.js use event loop for organizing different tasks which is coming in Node.js. So Node.js use stack, and it store all the tasks in a stack, and event loop manages to organize and hand over that task to thread pool. So thread pool is basically nothing but the threads which operating system already has. Let's say if any request of reading file occurs, event loop simply pick that task from task queue and then hand over that task to thread pool, and thread pool will basically do the actual operation of reading that file, and once the output will become ready, again the thread pool will inform event loop that task is over and output is ready, and then the event loop will basically give you an output. Well, this type of task management which event loop does, so if you are using any synchronous operation, well, this application doesn't have any event loop delay problem because it is giving consistent output. So that means there is no or very minimum synchronous operations application is using. Alright, so if you are getting this type of spikes which is more than 10-15 milliseconds, then that is the kind of thing you should definitely look into, and you should remove all the synchronous operation which you are using in your application, so that it will help to improve event loop delay. Okay, so let's move on to another task. Let's move on to another type of graph we have. It is nothing but active handlers. Well, as we already saw how event loop works, is it basically picks up all the tasks from task queue and then it handovers to the thread pool. Well, this is the type of handlers. Handlers are nothing but how many asynchronous operation is working at that particular time. So if I hover this, so at this particular time there are 13 active handlers, and you can see if we move further, it is going down and down. Well, you shouldn't have so many asynchronous tasks working, so because it will certainly decrease your performance. So all this type of estimation of all this type of graphs will help us to understand what is actually happening inside of our code. So, and the best thing about Linux.js is it auto suggests you issue that they have detected, but not necessarily that it will always be correct. We have to always keep our eyes on all these different graphs so that we can improve our application even further. Okay, so this is the type of graph which we got here, and we got three different types of issue, that is CPU usage, memory usage, and active handlers. So will surely help. Let me just go inside of our code and do some changes in our code. So currently I was using synchronous operation, so let me just remove that synchronous operation and use callback instead. Okay, so I think that should work. Let me just reprofile our application. Okay, it has started analyzing data again. Okay, so we haven't really improved anything. Okay, so let's try to use any asynchronous operation. So let me create one function here. And inside of it, I'll simply return promise. Okay, and I'll pick this. Okay, so now I'll simply resolve it here. Let's say true, and let me keep this import and in global scope. And this time I'm not giving 100 milliseconds, instead I'm giving 1000 milliseconds, and let's call this async one function here. All right, so I think that should be okay. Let's clear this up. Well, as you can see here, we got only two issues here. So let's understand. As you can see, we managed to keep our event loop delays almost below 0.5. okay, so that is the good thing. Again, the active handlers at each time was two active handlers because you are consistently reading file, so we are not doing any other operation. And then the memory usage was kind of high, so we can surely look into that to improve even further. All right, and CPU usage is definitely high because we are continuously using CPU in every single, we're continuously reading file in every single second. So if I simply increase this timer, so I'm expecting that CPU usage issue will also get resolved. CPU usage is still high, but then the memory issue is not that high. Okay, so in this way we can see what is actually happening inside of our program, and we can slowly improve that. So I think that's it for this video. See you in the next video. Bye.